Howdy, YouTube. Well, it's Bear here again. We had a long day today, but it was a good day. It was a good day. We started off in Springfield, Illinois, like we should have, where we were last night, and rode through some beautiful farmland all the way through southern Illinois. Stopped at a little town on the way called Carlinville. It's one of my favorite little stops. It's a neat place. It's your typical kind of Midwestern farming town. It's got the nice little square in the center of town, a little gazebo in the middle. Just really typical of small town America. And that's a reason why a lot of people take this tour and want to do Route 66 is to see what I call the real America, you know, see what America is really all about, and go to the small towns and the places that people don't normally go. You know, they go to the big tourist destinations or the big cities. Very few actually go to little towns, and that's where you meet the best people. That's where, and the people are real friendly, really friendly folks out there, really nice people. They're always really interested. They hear someone with an accent. They're, oh, where are you from? Where are you from? They want to know all about you and where you're from. Great little place. We stopped there as well and stopped at a place called the Refuge Coffee House, and it's a great place. So we go in, take a look around the little square for a little bit, and then go in and have a nice coffee and some pastries. And, pastry, yeah. I love pastries. Okay, anyway, I'm eating too much already. Anyway, stop there. Great place. If you're ever in Carlinville, go to the Refuge Coffee House. Great place. We go in there. Then afterwards, back on old Route 66. And then we get back on Route 66, stay on that until we get to the Mississippi River. Yeah, the Big Muddy, the mighty Mississippi. And we stop there and take a look at the old historic Route 66 bridge called the Chain of Rocks Bridge. And we stopped there for a bit, went out on the bridge, checked it out, took a bunch of pictures, and then got back on the road. Then kind of took a detour around St. Louis. Unfortunately, and this is true with a lot of the big cities along Route 66, is they really haven't done much to preserve Route 66 in a lot of places. There's a few things left in St. Louis, but just to get to them, you got to go through downtown St. Louis, and it is just a nightmare to try and get through there with a group. It is not easy. And for time's sake, too, it takes about an hour and a half extra. So instead, we just kind of take a detour around town, stop for lunch, had a nice lunch, and then we keep going. Got on the interstate for a little bit, just kind of because we have to. I hate going on the interstate, but there's places I can't avoid it. But we didn't go far, and then we stopped at the Missouri Route 66 State Park and Museum. And this is a little museum. It used to be a restaurant on Route 66, but it was willed to the State Park Department. And they've turned it into a museum. It's actually a neat little museum. And they've got a Yamaha Route 66 motorcycle. And it's a model of motorcycle that Yamaha put out that was called the Route 66, and they're one of the few places in the world that still have one. So we stopped there, took a look around the museum, bought some souvenirs in their gift shop, and I usually encourage people to buy stuff in the gift shops that help support not-for-profit places that it helps support, like Missouri State Parks or volunteers or something like that. There's so many places along the route to buy stuff, but I like to support the not-for-profit places because they're there not just to make a buck. They're there to help promote the road and make it a good place, and preserve the history. And that's really important to me. So after that, we got back on Route 66. We got on the motorway for just a few miles, unfortunately. I gotta quit doing these at night when I'm tired. And just went for a motorway for just a little while, just on the interstate for a short bit. And then got off and went down went down Missouri Road 100, which is also Route 66, and stayed on that through Gray Summit. It's a lovely road. Lots of nice twisty bits. It's an amazing road. It's incredible. So we went down that road, nice twisties, nice, on the bike. It felt great. Stayed on that until we got to Merrimack Caverns, which is the old hideout of Jesse James and his gang. It's where they used to go split up their loot after they robbed a train or a stage or a bank or something. So that's where they used to hide, was in the cave. Stopped there, stopped for an ice cream. I love my ice cream. So we stopped and had a really good ice cream and walked around inside a little bit. Then it was back on the route. Rode for a ways. Rode until we got went through Cuba, Missouri. No, we didn't go to Cuba, the island. We went to Cuba, Missouri. That would have been a hell of a wet ride if we went to Cuba, the island. But we went to Cuba, Missouri. Stopped there just west of town to see the world's largest rocking chair, which is really, I usually don't stop, but I had several people in the group that specifically requested it, and we were doing pretty good on time, so I said, okay, we'll take 10, 15 minutes here. But it was never on the route itself. It was built in 2008, so it really wasn't on Route 66 when it was actually Route 66, before they decommissioned the road. Oh, I'm tired. Okay. So they could decommission the road in 1984 and 85, and this wasn't there. I like to keep to the original Route 66. I like to see the original stuff because that's what we're here for, is more of the history. I mean, I don't blame people for opening stuff up and trying to make money. I mean, that's what we are here. But I like to keep it as original as possible. Just because that's what people are here to see, is the history of it, you know, the original route, not this stuff that somebody just threw up over, a few months, and then they're just there to make a buck. So, I mean, like I said, got nothing against it, but I want to see the original things. We want to see the original stuff. So, but we stopped there because everybody wanted to see it. I think primarily because Billy Connolly's Route 66 tour, his television program, they stopped there. He did a real, real disservice to Route 66. He just needs to rename it, not Route 66, but just a trip across America or something. I don't know, but it was a horrible program. He spent more time off of Route 66 in the program than he did actually on Route 66. So, Billy Connolly, if you ever see this, you did a crap job. I'm really disappointed. It could have been a really good program, but you just did a crappy job of showing Route 66. Anyway, but then after that, it was back on the old route for a ways. Then, just for time's sake, we jumped on the motorway for a bit to come into Rolla. We came into Rolla tonight and got to our hotel, went out, had some dinner, went to a local buffet, which is good. You know, it's kind of a new concept for people from the UK. It's like, what? All you can eat? All you can eat steak? What? So they enjoyed it. They thought it was pretty neat, pretty nifty to have something like that. And then it's back to the hotel. There's a few of them in the hotel lobby having a beer and about to go to bed. So that's about today. That's about it for today. We had a great time, and everyone's having a good time. So that's about it. So I think we'll talk to you tomorrow. So until then, keep the rubber on the road and the shiny side up. See you guys later. Bye.